folks ask me what's killing the bees these days, you know, since bees are so prevalent in the news, it's global economics, honestly. And I mean that by the way we move things around the globe. We've moved the varroa mite from Asia. We moved beetles from Africa. We've got a host of viruses from all over the globe that these pests can vector. Brood diseases, there's American fowl brood, there's European fowl brood. Both have their nuances. Some require destruction of the colony. There's also a host of not just pesticides or insecticides, but we're finding that herbicides and fungicides are also affecting bees, affecting their ability to absorb nutrition from the food sources they're using. So herbicides, fungicides, pesticides, insecticides, all the sides are a factor in affecting bee health. And then nutrition. For instance, in my county here in North Carolina, they've recently begun using an herbicide on the right-of-way, the power line right-of-ways. Those right-of-ways are great wildflower corridors for the honeybees, so a lot of the berry blooms and a lot of the fall flowers, the asters and goldenrods, which the bees need for food sources and pollen sources, don't exist after they spray, at least until the following season. If they get sprayed again, you know, you're losing that forage. So nutritional stress is a big one. That's what makes it so complicated to figure out why the bees are dying, because you've got nutritional stresses coupled with parasite stresses, coupled with brood diseases, coupled with all the sides that I mentioned. You can't put the finger on any one piece of that. It's a complicated puzzle. Varroa prefer drone brood. See that mite crawling around on that? They prefer drone brood because drones have a longer life cycle. It's 21 days to produce a worker bee, it's 24 days to produce a drone. And so mites can actually reproduce more in a drone cell. And so there's a mature female varroa mite, and she's probably, since this is still in the larval stage, not yet pupating, she's in there ready to, you know, lay this cell up with a bunch of eggs. And produce more mites. I'm sure we can find more mites. One in a cell is probably pretty common on a drone, some of these drone cells. Sometimes I've seen seven in one drone cell, seven mature female mites. See what we got here, if we got mites here. But like I said, this is the time of year, late July, early August, when mite populations peak, and you know, you gotta make a decision to act. There's a mite in this cell too. See it crawling around there. It's a parasite that attaches itself to the bee or to the larva. It lives off the hemolymph or blood of the bee. They vector viruses and disease. There it is on my finger. It's been likened to, the size of this parasite's been likened to us having like a grapefruit size parasite on our body. So it's really a tremendous size for a bee to deal with. But anytime you break open some drone brood, you're gonna scrape some from the hive because of it's poorly located, it's a good time to see if there's varroa mites in there. This one's already pupated. I don't see a mite on that one. But it's a good opportunity. There's a big fat female mite right there on this pupa. Just crawled out of sight. See it right down here. Tip of my hive tool. Right there on the hive tool. There's a host of registered products for treating for mites. I prefer using more organic options, just because our chemical options we've found have demonstrated, the mites have ultimately demonstrated resistance. And the more organic options, the organic acids, oxalic acid, formic acid, the mites the way they act on the mites can't generate resistance. They also leave no residues in the hive, which is really good. It's important for consumers to know that these honey supers, which we may harvest, that we took off first, they never receive a treatment, okay? The honey's harvested, the hive is left with its brood and its winter food, and that's where the treatment goes. So a lot of folks ask me when I'm selling honey at a market, well, do you treat your bees? And it's more than a two-sentence explanation. Yes, I do treat bees, and yes, I do feed bees, but I do it with organic methods, and I only do it into the area where they live and where they're going to spend the winter. I never do it into treat or feed into supers that'll ever be harvested for honey that would go into your, for you to consume. And that's really important. That's an ethical thing for beekeepers everywhere to hold a high standard and never place any kind of treatment or chemical product to deal with mites in your honey supers. It always goes into the brood nest. It won't do any good in the honey supers anyway because the mites are concentrated in your brood nest, so you need to be treating your brood nest anyway. That being said, the organic acids are safe on honey supers. I just choose to remove all honey before I use them. Formic acid is a naturally occurring compound in honey. It's in a bee stinger, and there's no higher levels of formic acid when you harvest a week or two after that treatment than there was beforehand. So it's a really safe in terms of the product. Not everything's got a silver lining though, so all these treatments are challenging in their timing and temperature restrictions. So if it's really too hot to use the organic acids, you have to lean on another one, which is the thymol based treatment. There's two products. First one is Apolife Var, and second is Apigard. They're basically a thymol-based product. Thymol originally coming from the thyme plant. They found kills mites and doesn't hurt bees. That's pretty good. It's a concentrated vapor. You place the wafer on the hive, and the vapors from that wafer kill mites as they exit the cells. The acids actually kill mites down in the cells, the formic acid does. So if you're killing mites in the cells, your treatment period is much shorter. If you're using thymol, it takes a 3-application or 2-application method over a period of the whole brood cycle, 21 to 24 days. And so it's a little more labor intensive. If the temperatures are right, I prefer the acids.